The Rockefeller study for a study has a commission group doing a study for a new society.
Right, yeah. The other thing about the, he's very much against the occult. And
yeah.
That's one thing that I agree with him on, the people turning to astrology. But, Dr. Fresco, can you eliminate the human being's desire to find out those things which he cannot answer? For example, where we came from, what happens after we die, and things like that. And what's going to happen to me tomorrow? Can you eliminate that?
I think to appropriateness in education, you can. We don't want to eliminate it. We just want to enable people to be able to hypothesize or perhaps reconstruct or extrapolate the origin of the world we live in and solar system, etc.
So the basis mainly, isn't it, for religions and things like this, is that people are...
Well, I think people are educated on the whole to be inadequate and need things. And I think that I'd like to see them off on their own.
And you also said that in the future you think that people will live forever?
I said that's a possibility.
Have you ever thought of the negative aspects of that?
Yes, I have. I know I don't think I'd...
For example, a guy like Hitler. If he knew he could live forever.
Well, no, he'd have been annihilated in the onslaught. I can think of the negative aspect, but I tell you something, off the top, I take it.
But I realize that anything is possible. But what about the overpopulation? Would you just move to different planets and...
I really can't go.
Nobody
died.
Your studio would be awful crowded then a couple hundred years from now.
Okay, so we'll have a mass show. Thanks. Okay, hello.
Hello, Larry.
Yeah.
How are you this morning?
Fine.
I called for this reason because I heard the gentleman that was on before this one. And to say that everybody that sees doesn't see people for what they are, I think is very false.
He didn't say everybody.
Well, because I never judge people on what they look like. I judge them how they keep their word and what they do, not by what they look like.
Do you say that you're average in that respect?
Well, I know quite a few people that do that. Now, I'll loan anybody a nickel to a dollar, and just to find out if they remember to keep their word to pay it back, because it's worth that little bit of money to...
Well, that's like you're running a test.
Pardon?
You're running a test.
No, I mean, like, you know, you work hard for your money. It's not a test, but...
Someone might give you back a dollar to get five next week and run away.
Oh, what I'm saying, basically, you can find out a lot by people just for that. Because I don't loan people
over dollars. Well, wouldn't you certainly say that you respected the gentleman's thoughts? A gentleman who's gone blind and felt he's found a better life for himself? I thought that was unusually interesting.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, the point is to say that people are all, that see are all blind and can't see things for what they really are is wrong.
Well, he didn't say that. He said most people, and I would tend to agree with him.
Well, you could say most people have bad manners and a few other things.
Correct.
But to say that a lot of people are like that, I don't think with the way communications and things are out in the open and people will discuss things in the open that they wouldn't discuss 20 years ago, and a lot of young people want to hear the truth these days much more than they did 20 and 30 years ago, I can't quite agree with them.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Well, we're in our waning moments. How would you sum up this 4 hours from the social scientific standpoint, Starlin?
I think this has been a very interesting discussion. I think there's been a lot of relevant comments from the callers on quite a variety of topics, some quite to the point or scientific, and I think that Dr. Fresco's new society presents some interesting alternatives. I think that one of the questioners 3 or 4 calls ago suggested that there'd be another program, either the same panel or people discussing the ways in which we can change this society. I think all of us, including the evil left, would be interested in that. And I think that's quite interesting topic, because there's many things we can do to change our society in the next few years.
Well, I hope to prevent the Holocaust that
is predicted.
Dr. Fresco hopes doesn't come true, but predicts. How would you sum it up, Virginia, from the anthropological view?
Well, I would agree that that it's been very interesting. I think the number of calls and the obvious sincerity and interest with which the people spoke would suggest that it's been interesting to others, too. I think one of the things that's been fun about this is that here we've been talking about one belief system, if you want to look at it that way, one view of what the desirable future would be, and our society is spawning these, many of these kinds of of ideas about what the future should be. I think that that yours, Jacque, is along the planned society concept. There are other people who are envisioning future societies, too, who would start with absolutely separate assumptions from yours, and they build their desirable. There are in-between people who are actually experimenting, who are not just designing them ideologically, but actually living them and experimenting. And to me, this is the excitement of this evolutionary stage that we're in.
Dr. Fresco, you cause excitement wherever you go.
That's the intent.
And I look forward to coming out and seeing your films. So I'm going to try to get Jacque to see them, too, because I know he'll find them interesting. And great pleasure having you on. I thank you, and we'll do it again.
Thank you. It's been a privilege.
Our guests have been Dr. Jacque Fresco. He is the founder of Socio Cyberneering. If you want more information, you can contact them during the day at 443-2895, 443-2895. Virginia Hine, instructor and research anthropologist, Arlen J. Doubler, social scientist, and earlier with us for 3.5 hours, the attorney and former chief prosecutor of the U.S. Attorney's Office, Neil Sonnett. This is WIOD Miami. We'll have a public service message and then Henry Barrow, 5 o'clock news.